You're watching NBAA TV. I'm Ed Hyland. The opening sessions for the NBAA BACE are just about ready to take off, and one of the most distinguished guests taking the stage is joining me now, Captain Jim Lovell, commander of the Apollo 13 mission. This is a real honor, sir. Thank you for joining us.
Well, it's a pleasure to be here. I was here some time ago, and I've always enjoyed, of course, aviation. NBAA, of course, is the epitome of all what's coming new and what's happening now, and so just to come up and kick tires, light fires is a lot of fun for me.
Of course, the aerospace industry, known for innovation, forward thinking, all that. Where do you think the industry is headed in that sphere, technology in particular?
Well, technology keeps coming along faster and faster, especially in the electronic fields and the communications field. Every time I look around, there's a new way to communicate, a new app on my iPhone, and the whole thing. So in that, I think it's really impacting the aviation industry now, because control systems and flight things are all sort of touch tone or automatic, maybe, but I think too far automatic. I think sometimes pilots are losing their actual basic aviation skills because they rely on electronics and on automation, and sometimes you have to do both.
And it was your skills, really, that brought back Apollo 13. So if we could also talk a little bit about space travel in general, where do you think that's heading, say, over the next 10 years or so?
Well, it seems to go in two directions. I mean, we have SpaceX and Elon Musk is talking about going to Mars in some early period, which I personally don't think that's possible just yet. And then we have people like Boeing who are building a spacecraft. Looks somewhat like the old Apollo, but much bigger, and they're having a big booster that they're having. So in two directions, I think it's going to go. I guess eventually it's going to have to come together. We're slowed down now, and of course with a new administration we have to figure out just where we want to go. But I think space travel, and I think NASA is really a positive organization for this country. We need technology, we need to keep going ahead, and that's the way to do it. I can't think of a better way to build up technology and new inventions.
Should we concentrate on the moon first and then Mars later?
Definitely. We should go back to the moon. As some people say, let's go directly to Mars, that's wrong. We should build up the infrastructure and the architecture to land on the moon, stay on the moon, be very comfortable going back and forth, then using that and expanding it to eventually go to Mars.
And lastly, sir, if you would mind, there's a career day here at NBAA BACE, young people getting involved. How important is that to bring up the next several generations to really enlighten them about the past and also the future?
Well, every time I go someplace, there's lots of young people that are still very much interested in space technology, all aspects, aviation, plus spacecraft and things like that. We ought to encourage them to keep going ahead, because I think there's a bright future still in the aviation and space technology that hasn't been explored yet.
Jim Lovell, thank you so much for joining us.
And
this is NBAA TV. Pleasure, sir. Thank you.